Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now we come to the best part of the service, which Amen. Is the Word.
Amen. Yes.
And I'm going to present the speaker, but I can't present him like he would present him on Sunday morning. So, in the persons of Brother Jerry Mills.
Associates and the saints of the Most High God. If you have it, say amen, or if you're still looking, say I'm traveling. We're going to read verses 1 through 3. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined unto me and heard my cry. He brought me up also out of an horrible pit, out of the miry clay, set my feet upon a rock and established my goings. And he hath put a new song in my mouth, even praise unto our God. Many shall see it and fear and shall trust in the Lord. Saints of God, I stand before you today because there comes a point in time in our salvation when all we can do is wait. Saints of God, we stand before people, we stand before our situations, and we pray, and we sing, and we jump, and we run, and we clap, and we do everything we can to get our situation to move, change, or get better. But what the Lord is trying to tell us is just wait. Saints of God, I stand before you because I have a situation where all I can do right now is just wait on God.
All right now.
I don't know what's going to come of it. I don't know where it's going to go. I don't know how it's going to happen. I don't know where I'm going to be when this thing comes. But all I can do is wait.
Amen.
Because there are doors that the Lord wants to open, and there are things that the Lord wants to change. But in order for them things to change and those doors to open, I have to wait until He's ready to put me in the place that He wants me to be. Say to God, God is doing something in our lives right now that all we have to do right now is wait. Yes. We've prayed, we've fasted, we've sung our songs of Zion, and we've done everything we can. But right now, the Lord is saying, wait.
Thank you, Jesus.
All that there is to do is just wait and sing songs of Zion and make melody in our hearts. God has done everything. He's doing everything. He's moving people out of the way. This is like a chess match, if you can think about it. God is putting His pieces in places so that He can make the final move and execute His judgment. Because when God is ready to make the move after we've waited and done all we can do to stand, the Lord is going to make a way, a perfect way. Because when that time of waiting is over, our minds will be ready. Our situation is going to be perfect. And we're going to be ready to move right into that thing. We've all waited for our money to get better, our problems to get better. We've waited for that new house, the new car, a wife, a husband, our wives to get better, our husbands to get better, our children to get better. But the only thing to do now is just wait on the Lord. He's the great mind changer. He's the great way maker. He's the one that we need to do everything we need. And all He needs us to do right now is just wait. We struggle with everything. Struggle not. We need not to put our hands in the situation. We need not to look at the situation and think, if I just change this or move this or do this, I can make this situation better. But God still trying to tell us, just wait. We think we have a way of doing things. We think that we can make a way. We think that we can do it, but we cannot do it. God does not want us to do.
That's right, sir. That's right.
At this point in time in my salvation, I found myself in a holding pattern of just waiting on the Lord. Tried to do things. I've looked at things this way. I'm a person. I'm an analytical, logical person. And I look at things and I think, if I just do it this way, if I just move it like this, if I just do this and that, but all I hear the Lord say is wait. This is a great recipe that the Lord is cooking up.
Jesus.
I had somebody tell me I was having problems cooking some food. And they told me, you're too impatient. But when God starts to make this recipe and cook this thing up, He puts all the ingredients together. He cuts the onions up. He cuts all the celery up. And He kneads His dough. And He starts to work that thing out. And He starts to do it. And He starts to move. And that thing starts to take shape. And we look at it and we say, oh, there it is. It's ready. But God says, no, hold on. I got to put it in the oven.
Come on.
And when He puts it in the oven, He takes all the impurities out, and all the good flavor, the good savor starts to rise up and take shape.
Yes,
the juices start to marinate inside that thing, and everything starts to take its place.
Come on.
But if you try to cook it too fast, everything won't take its place, and everything won't be ready. child of the same generation. I want everything right now. I want results. If I study for 2 hours, if I study for 3 hours, I expect an A. We expect things to go the way that we think they should go, but God is saying, not so. I don't care if you do this, that, or the other. I don't care if your intentions are right, wrong, or whatever, but God is telling you to wait. Nothing's going to come out of it unless you wait until he's done making his way.
That's right.
Everything we do, everything, we have to wait on God.
Yes.
And he trains us from the first day that we get saved. He teaches us. First time we have to do something to wait, it takes a minute. God shows up. Then after that, he teaches you to wait for a day. And then a week, and then a month, and then years. But we go from faith to faith to faith. He's teaching us to wait upon him and to grow. We have to grow in God. We have to be built up in him. But in order to get to that point that God wants us to be at, we have to wait on God. There are situations, there are people in our life that make us so angry. And we look at the person and we say, oh my God, you need to change. But no, what God is trying to do is change us on the inside. I have problems in my life that I'm like, I want this to change. I want that to change. I want this to change. But it's not that that needs to change. It's the change that needs to happen within me. The time that I've waited for God to make a change in my life, he's built me. He's building something within me, because this thing that has been going on in my life that has bothered me the most, it has taken its shape within me and bothered me to my core. But God has given me strength through it all.
Yes.
And as long as I've waited for him, he's given me peace. He's given me joy, and he's given me my season of rest in the midst of all of it. But I'm continually waiting on God to make the move in my life. If I make the move, then I destroy everything. If I put my hand to it, I move it the wrong direction. You do not want to wait 3 months and God says, all I need you to wait is 4 months and mess it up in three. You never know when that change is going to come. The change just might be right around the corner.
Come on now.
That house you're waiting for, you may think that this is the one that God wants you to have, but no, he wants you over here. But until the people are kicked out of this house and the price of it drops, he wants you to wait.
Go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
That car you want, God ain't made it yet. The 2012 car that he wants you to have, it ain't even out yet.
Ooh,
so you gotta wait till it comes.
Yes.
Your kids are acting up in school. Your kids ain't treating you right. You gotta wait, because there's a point in time that God triggers something in their mind. But he has to let them, but you have to let them grow.
Yes.
There's a time for everything. There's a season for everything. Everything that we want, if we just wait on God. Say to God, this is personal. I'm talking to myself because I'm waiting. I'm waiting on God to do something. You have to be patient, and patience possesses your soul.
Yes, yes.
Waiting for this thing, we grow in God. We start to see every little thing in God. We start to see the small things that give us joy. Because if you rush this thing, you're going to miss some things. There's going to become a point in time in your life that you're going to need those things there, that God is trying to teach you in the midst of waiting. You have to go from faith to faith. Let your strength be built up in God. Because this race is not given to the swift nor the strong, but those that endure to the end. Wait. Wait, I say on the Lord, wait.
Yes, yes.
Don't be in a rush to make this thing happen. Mm. Don't be in a rush to see results. Mm. Because you may not get the results you want. Mm. God may be preparing you for the worst. And if he showed you right now, it would devastate you. But he's trying to work something out in your mind and in your heart to prepare you for the thing that it's coming. Let him bless your mind. Let him build you. Saints of God, there are things that we want. There are things that we want God to do. There are things that we are looking for God to move in our lives. But until he is ready to move, until he is ready to build, until he is ready to open that door, there's nothing we can do but wait. That job you want, God ain't ready for it yet. He ain't ready for you to have it just yet. You want it, but God, in his time, he's going to give it to you. And it may not be that job. It may be a job somewhere else doing something else.
That's right.
Because, saints of God, I tell you, I tested for that Cincinnati firefighter's job, and I wanted it so bad, and it passed me by. But I waited, and the Lord put me with a fire department that ain't having the financial hardship that Cincinnati's having right now. But if I would not have waited on God, I would be looking at losing my job right now. But all I had to do was wait. 2 years ago, saints of God, I was trying to be a fireman and I was trying to get into nursing school. I kept trying. I kept doing stuff thinking, oh, I could do this. Let me talk to this person. I even started to talk to people that were high up in politics that can make moves.
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, yeah, I can make this move, this move, this move, and I'll be in. But it didn't happen. It didn't happen at all. But when I started to wait on God, he set that thing up so perfect. I had to go the long way around, but I didn't realize it until I got here that the long way was the right way that I needed to go.
That's right. Go ahead.
Say to the Most High God, I needed to be at the job I'm at right now in order to go to nursing school, because now that the job I'm at, they have tuition reimbursement and they will pay for my school.
All right.
Wait. That thing, if you just wait on God, is going to come out so perfect. It's going to blow your mind. That thing going to look so good. You're going to think, how in the world did I get here? It's going to look so good that you couldn't have thought of a way to even make it fall this way. Ooh, when God is done blowing your mind, you will, oh my God. You're going to look back and think, that we have, everything that we need is in God,
yes.
But everything that we get is in due season.
Uh-huh.
If you pick an apple before it's time, it's not ripe, it's sour to the taste. You have to wait until that thing starts to change colors. You have to wait until it starts to soften up.
Uh-huh.
You have to wait until the juices start to savor inside of that apple, until the season is ripe for the picking. Run over and you'll keep trying to pick them up and pick them up and pick them up.
seen some. I've seen His will work.
Yes, yes.
So perfect.
Yes.
Just perfect will. There are things that have happened in my life that if I would have started to do things my way, I would have made a mess.
Yes.
But that's the great thing about waiting. You don't have to do anything.
That's right.
Nothing at all. Just sit down. Uh-huh. Just sit. Cross your legs and wait on God.
That's it.
Because when He comes, He coming with a truckload. And He going to back that thing up.
That you have to follow to the T. To the T. This is Thanksgiving dinner. If you rush it, it's not going to taste good. But if you let it marinate,
that's right,
and you give it time to cook, and you let everything take its place, and all the juices and the flavor just come together, when you pull it out of the oven, it's going to be perfect. And that's when God pulls us out of the oven, and we'll be tried and true. So, saints of God, if you didn't get anything else out of this message tonight,
I want you to wait. Don't make a move. Don't do this. Don't crack your husband upside the head. Don't crack your wife upside the head. Don't kick your kids out the house. Wait. That house you're waiting for, I'm telling you, God knows what you want. He knows exactly what you want. But he wants you to wait. I'm telling you. You just gotta wait. Because he know your situation. He know your problems. He know everything. He know how much money you make. He know how many kids in your family. He know what your wife want and how she want it. But you just gotta wait. And in waiting, do not stop praising God, thanking him in the midst of it. Praise God. Praise him for everything you have and everything, give thanks. Because in the midst of waiting, it's going to get hard. You're going to feel, oh my God, I'm so tired of this, I'm so tired of that, I'm so tired of this. But praise him, and he renews your strength. He renews your strength daily. Pray, he renews your strength. Fast, he renews your strength. Just keep waiting. Don't give up. Wait. Just wait. Just wait. And it's going to happen. Trust me. I know it will. Saints of God, if there's anyone here that don't have the Holy Ghost that would like to get prayer, this is an altar call to come up and just get a prayer. This won't put you in the church, and this don't make you be in the church. This is prayer for God to bless your soul, to bless you to receive the Holy Ghost. If you want to get prayer, come on up here. The kids are already starting to come. Just come up and line up. And as always, Cortez is first. Cortino's first. I don't know why I call him Cortez. Come on up here and get prayer.
I want to be like you, be like you. I want to be like you, be like you.
I want to
and protection from all.
I wanna live like you, live like you. I wanna live like you, live like you. Oh Lord, I wanna live like you. Oh Lord, I wanna live like you. I wanna be like.
Thank you, Lord God, for your way is perfect, Lord God. Lord Jesus, I love you. Thank you.
everybody say,
amen.
Let everybody say,
amen.
Everybody say,
amen. Amen. Amen.
Sing yourself a song.